Hi folks, welcome to another episode of Gourmet on the Road, and we're in Mangalore, and in this episode we're exploring the street food of Mangalore. I visit Seetharam's Charmuri, a rite of passage for most Mangaloreans, and later stopped by at the city's most famous VADA shop for some scrumptious deep-fried goodness. Stay tuned to find out more. So right now we've come to the Lighthouse Road. We're just near St. Aloysius College, and we've been told about this place called Seetharam's Charmuri Chaat counter. So this is like a food truck that's right here. In the special in the Charmuri. So in Charmuri try maadbodha. Charmuri or mixed puff rice definitely packs a punch. It's got the chili heat, it's got the raw mango, it's got tomatoes. It's all kind of come together with coconut oil. Mangaloreans swear by coconut oil. So this is Seetharam, and Seetharam has been making the Charmuri at this location for the last 38 years he's been here. So he had a small little shop where he would make the chaat. The area has changed, and even his petty shop, as he calls it, is now a food truck. And what you definitely need with the Charmuri is some sugarcane juice. So if you have the Charmuri, the cold sugarcane juice is mandatory. So this is a great combo, the spicy Charmuri chaat and a cold sugarcane juice. So we are here at our second must-do street food stop here in Mangalore, and this is Balli's, named after the owner Baliga. This place, this spot has been around for the last 30-40 years, and it's famous for one thing, fritters or vadas. Cabbage kodi, aloo bonda kodi, stone cutlet kodi. Oh, so this is hot, so this is a cabbage bhaji. Oh, nice. See the cabbage leaves here, and of course there's plenty of, I think, gram flour. You can see some chili. I think the one thing about the bhajis here, I think you have one of those, and you probably set for a couple of hours at least. So these are big, large, and for somebody with a big appetite. The vegetable cutlet next. You can see all the rava that it's been crumbed in. Oh, lovely. Definitely a lot of potato. There's some chili as well. And maybe there's some cauliflower in this. There's some coriander that I can see, that I can taste as well. Brilliant. This is a medu vada. This is a roundel of sort. It's not the donut-shaped medu vada, but it's studded with, you can see the chilies, you can see the curry leaf. I think this is going to be a flavorful medu vada. So basically, the vadas here are so flavorful that there is no chutney or no ketchup or nothing. You just have the vada as it is. You can see a big sliver of chili. This is going to be a spicy bite. You can feel the kick of the chili. This is beautiful. The aloo bonda or the batata vada. Oh. What I like about the aloo bonda is that the casing is just doing enough to contain all the potatoes, but it's not really interfering in the potato and spice flavor that is there in this aloo bonda. The place is getting crowded. I think I'm going to take my bhajis away. These are not fritters that you could probably snack on. If you snack on one of these, you can probably forget a meal. I think that's the reason why it's so popular. If you look at, we just had a minute or two of relative calm, but now again the evening crowd is back here. Very reasonable, probably not more than 100 rupees, but they're packed in flavor, of course, also packed in calories, but most importantly, they leave you feeling happy and satisfied, which is why I think the Balli shop here is as popular as it is. Do give a thumbs up and leave a comment if you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to share and subscribe to Food Lovers TV to catch all episodes from Gourmet on the Road. Happy eating!